When the World Health Organization described January, it said it was going to be a tough one. It really is all hands on deck. This is evident from the picture in mid-January across Europe and the UK. This country-by-country guide shows the different measures put in place by EU countries to try to curb alarming rises in infection and death rates. Many countries will review policies at the end of January, in line with the effectiveness too of vaccination efforts, which varies greatly from one country to the next. There is a list of EU-approved, third-party countries which currently includes Australia, Japan, New Zealand, Rwanda, Singapore, South Korea, and Thailand, from which arrivals are also allowed. The same is true for China, assuming reciprocity occurs, i.e. that China accepts EU arrivals. On 16 December 2020, the EU decided to remove Uruguay from the list of safe countries because of its deteriorating epidemiological situation. Despite a brief relaxation of the rules over Christmas and New Year, Austria has been in lockdown since November 3 and will stay so until 24 January. Unlike many of its EU neighbors, ski resorts have been open since 24 December but operating under restrictions. Only people arriving from Australia, Finland, Ireland, Iceland, Japan, New Zealand, Norway, South Korea, Uruguay, and the Vatican are allowed unrestricted access into the country. From 15 January, other EU plus citizens, EU-EEA countries not on the list above, plus Switzerland, Andorra, Monaco, San Marino, the Vatican and the UK, entering Austria must register online for pre-travel clearance and carry the document with them upon arrival. They must then quarantine for 10 days. The can, test out, of quarantine with a negative molecular biological or antigen test at the earliest from the 5th day after entry. All access to third-party countries is not currently given, with a few exceptions such as essential medical staff and key workers. Belgium has extended its COVID-19 travel restrictions where non-essential shops are closed and curfews are in place across many regions. Euronews reported that Prime Minister Alexander De Croo said it was too early to relax the rules. Belgium operates according to the ECDC's traffic light system. Anyone arriving from a red zone, which currently includes most of Europe, will have to go into quarantine for 10 days, but they can test out on day 7 with a negative result. Non-essential travel to and from outside EU and Schengen countries remains prohibited, and all passengers arriving in Belgium by air or sea must fill in a public health passenger locator form 48 hours before arrival. Based on their answers, visitors will receive a test message if they are high risk and need to quarantine. If they do, they must take a COVID-19 test on days 1 and day 7. If visitors do not receive a text message, they do not need to quarantine.